Building a Voron is complicated enough, so I built mine stock. But after putting it through some wear and tear, I realized there were a few things I could have done different. If I were building my Voron again, these are some of the mods I wish I'd install on day one. Here's the first example of learning things the hard way. I started noticing scratches on my top acrylic panel, and for the longest time, I couldn't figure out why. Turns out, if you're not careful with the PTFE tube going into the toolhead, it can stick out too much and rub against the panel during prints. This simple printed guide fixed the issue completely. It basically works by keeping the tube out of the way while it's printing, and it's such a small print for something that protects your panel in the long run. Next are the stock front idlers. They work fine at first, but over time I noticed they were splitting open, as did many others online. All the belt tension slowly adds up and crack begins to form in the printed parts. The beefy idler mod solved this with a stronger design that distributes the tension much better. And as a bonus, some of the newer two-head designs actually require this mod due to its smaller footprint. For me, this is my only printer, so if it cracked before I could replace them, I would be stuck waiting for replacement parts. So it's better for me to replace them sooner than later. If your Voron kit still ships with an Omron induction probe, this is probably the most important upgrade on the list. Honestly, I never had much luck with the Omron probe, and eventually it caused a crash that dug straight into my PEI sheet. That was the moment I realized it was time to try something else. Enter the Clicky probe. It's not the fastest probe in 2025, especially compared to the newer eddy current probes like Beacon or Cartographer, but it's a lot cheaper. It's been solid and reliable for me for the past 2 years, and if I could only pick one mod from this list, Clicky would be the one. I also use Clicky as virtual Z end stop now, which means I no longer rely on a separate switch for Z homing. That change alone gave me a much more consistent first layer. The next mod is about making the printer less of a chore to use. I used to sit in front of the printer at the start of every print with pliers in my hand, snipping off filaments that ooze out of the nozzle. It felt silly after a while. The whole point of this machine is to press print and let it run. So by the time I got around to it, Bamboo Lab had released their silicone scrubber, which I end up getting some third party ones. And they seem to be much kinder on the nozzle compared to the brass wire brush. It doesn't always catch every blob, but it's good enough to keep any stray filaments from messing up the print. Now the next one seems almost too simple to mention, but moving a fully enclosed Voron Trident is not exactly fun, especially with all the panels bolted on. There's basically nowhere solid to grab the machine. Instead of taking the panels apart or risk snapping the skirts in half, bolt-on handles mounted directly to the top frame suddenly give me a proper gripping point, and those handles came in handy right away, because the next mod required flipping the whole machine over. Here's the part I'm least proud of. For the longest time, I ran my Voron with a spaghetti mess underneath, because flipping the entire printer just to access the electronics was such a pain. Literally. Let's just say the floor wasn't the only thing that panel fell onto. This is where the inverted electronics mod comes in. This is specific to the Voron Trident, but I've seen similar mods for Voron 2.4 as well. So the general idea is just to have better access to your electronics. The inverted bay means all the electronics are mounted facing upward, so now I can just remove the top panel and have instant access whenever I need to check a cable or swap something out. So those are the upgrades I wish I had built into my Voron from the very beginning. They're not flashy, but each one solved a real problem I ran into and made the machine much easier to live with. I hope this list gave you something to consider for your build. For those who have built a Voron, what's the upgrade you never skip again? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one.